हिंदू मैरिज इज़ लाइक फेरी टेल्स, फुल ऑफ कलर्स, सो मैनी रिचुअल्स, सो मैनी सेरेमनीज, फुल ऑफ लाइफ, जॉय, डांस, म्यूजिक एंड वॉट नॉट. बट देर आर मैनी थिंग्स विच नीड्स टू बी अंडरस्टैंड वैन वी टॉक अबाउट लीगल पार्ट. हेलो एवरी वन, आई एम डॉक्टर प्रिया सिपाहा एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एसेंशियल कंडीशंस ऑफ वैलिड हिंदू मैरिज अंडर हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट 1955. ऑल्दो देर आर 10 सैक्रमेंट्स ऑफ हिंदू मैरिज, बट बाय द टाइम देर आर मैनी अमेंडमेंट्स एंड नाउ देर आर 5 एसेंशियल्स विच हैज़ बीन मैंशनड अंडर सेक्शन 5 ऑफ हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट. Essential conditions of the valid Hindu marriage has been mentioned under Section 5 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955. Basically, it is divided into 5 parts. The first one is monogamy, the second is mental capacity, third, age of the party, fourth, prohibited degree of relationship, and fifth is sapinda relationship. Now, let's understand these things in detail. Now, the first one is monogamy. Monogamy means there must be only one marriage. No second marriage is allowed, and not even third marriage. That means no polygamy and no polyandry. As per Section 11, if there is a failure of this condition, then that marriage will be considered as a void marriage. Apart from it, under Section 17 of the Act, that also defined that it is considered as an offense for which punishment has been mentioned under Section 494 and 495 of the Indian Penal Code. That is 7 years of punishment and 10 years of punishment respectively with fine. Now the second essential is mental capacity. This particular clause has been inserted in 1976 amendment. This clause states that the parties to the marriage should not suffer from unsoundness of mind, mental disorder, or insanity. In all the cases given in Section 5, Clause 2, the party is regarded as not having the mental capacity to solemnize the marriage. So, if a party who solemnized the marriage is suffered from unsoundness of mind, mental disorder, or insanity, the marriage is voidable at the opinion of the other party. Now, here the important point is, if this problem occurs, then marriage is voidable, not void, and that too at the opinion of the other party. That means if other party wants to continue this marriage, they may continue. So the conditions are, neither party at the time of marriage is firstly incapable of giving a valid consent due to his or her unsoundness of mind. This is first. Now second is, neither party at the time of marriage has been suffering from mental disorder of such a kind or to such an extent as to be unfit for marriage and the procreation of children. And lastly, it has subjected to recurrent attacks of insanity. Now, in any of these cases which are not fulfilled, then marriage is voidable under Section 12(1)(b) of the Act. Now, in this particular clause, earlier epilepsy was also there, but now it is omitted in the Marriage Law Amendment Act 2001. Now, this clause is debatable. There are many judgments, many cases pertaining to this particular mental capacity, because this particular thing is also a ground for divorce. Now, if you have to consider mental capacity or mental illness, no matter it is unsoundness or insanity or any other type of mental disability or mental illness, that it has to be very precise and what is the gravity of that particular disease, because on the basis of that particular gravity, it can be considered as a ground for divorce. Like if it is not curable, then it can be a ground. If it can be cured, then it is not a ground for divorce. Moreover, there are also cases where spouse are ready to live with the other person. If there is a case of insanity, because insanity is something which is not of a permanent nature, and it depends upon the attack of insanity also. So there are many things which is related to this particular context. But yes, as per section 5(2) of Hindu Marriage Act, it is considered, mental capacity is considered as a valid essential point to get marriage and for the validation of Hindu marriage. Now, third point is age of the party. Age of the party means, although when this particular act was enacted, at that time the age of a girl was 15 and the boy was 18. But by the time, now in the present scenario, the major or the age of marriage of a girl is 18 and for the boy it is 21 years of age. Although if any minor child is married, that particular marriage is not considered as null or void as per Hindu law. But yes, there is punishment for this. Section 18A of this act defines a punishment of 15 days and a fine of 1000 rupees for anyone who forced any minor girl or boy to get married. But the Prohibition of Child Marriage Act 2006 is having more severe punishment for this act, because as per that, if any person are conducting, performing, helping, abetting any child marriage, then there is a rigorous punishment of 2 years and fine of rupees 1 lakh. Now the fourth essential is prohibited degree of relationship. Now, prohibited degree of relationship means there are certain relationships in which marriage is prohibited as per Hindu law. These relationships are considered as very, very pious, where marriage cannot be performed. So let's have a look on this section. Section 3G defines persons falling within prohibited degree of relationship. They are, if one is a lineal ascendant of the other. Now, lineal ascendant means if there is a direct blood relationship with other person, those person cannot be married or they are in a prohibited degree of relationship. Similarly, as per the second point, if one was the wife or the husband of a lineal ascendant or descendant of other, that means no one can marry other's wife or other's husband, no matter it is related directly from the ascendant or descendant side. Now, as for the third point, which is pretty confusing, that if one was the wife of the brother, now here there is no confusion, wife of brother means one cannot marry his bhavi, or of the father's or mother's brother, that means wife of the father's or mother's brother, then also he cannot marry. Or if she is a wife of the grandfather's or grandmother's brother, then also he cannot marry. Then if there are two, both are brother and sister, that means there cannot be a marriage between brother and sister. Similarly, uncle and niece, aunt and nephew, or children of brother and sister, that means cousins, or of two brothers or of two sisters, which also includes relationship by half or uterine blood as well as by full blood. Secondly, there cannot be a marriage between illegitimate blood relationship as well as legitimate blood relationship. Similarly, the prohibited degree also includes relationship by adoption as well as by blood. Now, in simple words, we can say that anyone cannot marry either of the following person. First, his lineal ascendant. Second, wife of his lineal ascendant. Wife of his lineal descendant. then brother's wife, then wife of his father's brother, then wife of his mother's brother, then wife of his grandfather's brother, then wife of his grandmother's brother, then sister, sister's daughter, father's sister, mother's sister, father's sister's daughter, father's brother's daughter, and mother's brother's daughter. Similarly, a woman cannot marry either of the following person. First, her lineal ascendant, then husband of wife, husband of her lineal ascendant, then husband of her lineal descendant, then brother, then father's brother, mother's brother, nephew, sister's son, uncle's sons, father's sister's son, mother's sister's son, and mother's brother's son. Now here also there are certain exceptions. In some of the state, some of the prohibited degree of relationship has been adopted and it is followed as per customs. But whenever anything is followed as per custom, that has to be proved that that particular custom is certain, reasonable, ancient, and it is continuous. This is a essentiality of any custom and it should not be against the public policy. So if it is as per law, then that particular customs can be adopted, because in some of the states marriage between uncle and niece are accepted. Similarly, there are certain states where marriage between maternal side of brother and sisters are accepted in Hindu law also. So these are the conditions and these are the exceptions also. Now the last essential is sapinda relationship. Now sapinda is something which is considered as a very close blood relationship. Pindadan is very, very important in Hindu rituals and which can be performed only by those person who are having a very close and a direct blood relationship. And if this particular ritual is performed, then it is prohibited degree of relationship under Hindu Marriage Act, that is sapinda relationship. Now as per the amendments and as per the changes in the Hindu Marriage Act, now this particular sapinda relationship has been now described as a three generation ascended line by the maternal side and five generation ascended line from the paternal side. That means any person cannot be get married from five generation or within five generation from paternal side and within third generation from maternal side. This is sapinda relationship. Section 18B of the Act describes punishment for both prohibited degree of relationship of this particular act and also sapinda relationship. If anybody is getting married out of this clause, then he will be punished for 1 month and a fine of rupees, and these type of marriage will be considered as a void marriage. That's all about the essential conditions for the Hindu Marriage Act. I hope you like the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. You may also follow us on various social media platforms by the name of Law Colloquy. We are also having our website, that is lawcolloquy.com. So that's all for today. See you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.